morning. How is your day going? I hope you're doing well. I wanted to thank you for giving me some of your time today. I'm thrilled to bring you kind of the status update of the Take Me to 2019 Project Pan started by Abbie, Make Life Your Runway. I'm going to go on and link her channel up here in the card above and in the description box below. She is a fabulous person. You need to check her out. Absolutely wonderful. She inspired me to jump into this Project Pan. I had tons of fun with the makeup items. In fact, I'm kind of, you know, feeling the push to keep it going. So I don't know, like, we'll kind of close out the finale for this, but I'm going to keep you posted on a couple of the products that I'm going to go on and continue rolling over, because I feel like I've got the momentum that I'm ready to finish them and get them out. So without further ado, let's go on and start off with the eyeshadows that I was able to finish. The first thing I went through, I wanted to finish what was left of my Too Faced Sugar Pop palette, in particular the shade Peach Fuzz. So I'll go on and put a picture over here so you can see what it looked like. It was a really beautiful kind of a white peach shadow, and what I would do is I would layer it on top of this NYX. It's a concealer pencil, but it had a really awesome yellow matte base to it that just really gave a lot of brightness, a lot of depth to that shadow. So I enjoyed using this pencil till I got to the point that I could no longer sharpen it. It fell out. So I was just like, done. And what I have decided to do for this year is I loved that peach shadow so much that I'm actually going through with the peach shade from the Too Faced Peanut Butter and Jelly palette in combination with Mac's Gold Bit. And I'm wearing it on top of my NYX Jumbo Eyeshadow Pencil and Milk all over my lid. Very similar effect. It's not quite as bright as Peach Fuzz was, but I feel like I'm getting a very similar effect, and that makes me ecstatic. So that feels really good. In terms of finishing this palette, I legit finished the three larger pans of shadow through various panning projects and looks. I've had this palette several years. And in the smaller pans over here, I did have pan in like the blackberry shade, which was like a matte purple. I had some pan in the bubblegum shade that was up here and in the coral. And then I'd use the turquoise that was down here. And then there was like a shimmery purple that I'd used. And then this top, I think it was Malted Milk Ball. Is that, yes, Malted Milk Ball. This shade was just a dud. So I went on and used what I could. And then I did make a couple of Franken shadows, but the mix ended up being expired. And so it wasn't worth it to me. I just decided to take them out of the pan and then, you know, finish off that peach shadow. So get to get rid of some more packaging. That is exciting. And then that takes me to the next shadow that I was able to make a ton of progress on. And that is my crease shadow. And I really wanted to go through with Kat Von D's Raw Power. I fell in love with the Rewind shade when I panned the Mivita Loca Remix palette. In fact, I will also include that Pan That Palette finale video if you haven't gotten a chance to watch it. So stay tuned for that. But here is where I got with Raw Power. I'm so excited because finished! Love, love, loved this shadow. I used it on my eyes. I used it as a blush. When I got close to the end, because I just loved the tones of this. It works really well. It's kind of helped me to find my go-to amber, classic amber look. I never thought that I would love a red eyeshadow as much as I do, but thanks to Rewind and Raw Power, it is going to be something that is forever a staple in my collection, especially wearing it with peaches and oranges. I cannot get enough of this combination. So what I'm wearing now is actually for this my Single Ladies and My Man Matt Project Pan Challenge. So I'll go on and link that video as well for my intro. But I'm wearing it in my crease. I love this. And the shade that I'm using now is Max Cranberry, if you're wanting something that is quite similar to Raw Power. So love, love, love. I'm able to finish that and move it out, which takes us into the next shadow that I was able to finish. And I wanted to go through with Kat Von D's Thunderstruck, and I mixed it with a couple other shades that I had that were just kind of on the last little bits. I wanted to go on and move them out. And so I pressed them all into one highlighting shade that was similar to Molder from the Kat Von D Mivita Loca Remix. It's not quite a white, but it's not quite a bone shade. It's not quite a yellow. It had kind of that duochrome effect of all of those kind of rolled into one. And so when I put all those shadows together, I got a very similar payoff to Molder, and I repressed them into this Becca compact that used to have a gradient glow. As you can see, I finished it. So, yes! Get to move out some more packaging. And once I got to a point that my Kat Von D shades were noticeably expired as I went through that Pan That palette, I decided to go on and bring in my Lorac Pro 2. I needed to anyway, because two of the shades were quite comparable. So what I did was I brought in this palette In fact, this is going to be part of my pan that palette for this year. But I went through with the shades beige because when I got to the point where I'd had an eye infection, using my Thunderstruck Franken Shadow out of this on my eyes, I really was hesitant to try that again. So I sanitized it. I continued to use it as a face highlight once I was done with that eye infection. But then I went through with beige from this palette and I didn't have any problems. So I was able to completely finish that shadow. And then I also went through when I finished my, I changed, what was that shade called? Strutter from the Mi Vida Loca Remix palette to be a slight bit warmer. So it was more like Noble. And when I finished that combination and its backup, then I went through with what was left of light brown and used that. And I finished that a couple days ago. So very, very exciting. I'm feeling so like accomplished with finishing eyeshadow. I feel like I'm on that wave of Project Pan where it's like I'm finishing a ton of things at once and then it's going to get slow for a while. And then perhaps I'm going to finish a ton of things at once. But I'm really feeling the momentum with moving out some shadow. And then lastly for eyeshadow, I brought in this MAC Mariah Carey quad with the shade, or the palette is called I'm That Chick You Like. And as you can see, I've been working on this espresso brown down here. It actually cracked. I haven't had a chance to repress it. I'm kind of debating just using it in its particles like this because I'm honestly a little bit nervous about repressing it since it was a little bit more fragile this way. But basically, I've been going in. I'm using this in my brows. I use it as a liner. I love this shadow. And honestly, I've got a little bit less than halfway. So I'm very impressed with the progress I was able to make, and I'm just going to continue working on it as is till it's done. It'll be my very first MAC shadow that I've ever finished, so that's pretty exciting. And really what inspired this, kind of moving along, keeping the pace going, what really inspired me to jump into this Project Pan was this blush. It is my Clinique Cheek Pop in the shade Cola Pop. I still have not hit pan on this blush. I'm okay with that. In fact, I'm inspired to... Well, not necessarily inspired. I am determined to hit pan, which is one of the reasons why I'm continuing like with the red look, because I love this combination together. I did get to a point where you can really see the wear down on the blush and the imprint is not near as deep as it used to be. But this blush, oh, I feel like we are going to be working together for a very, very long time. So I'm happy with what I've been able to do so far. And in fact, my pace was a little bit slower, admittedly, because there were a couple of weeks that I felt that push with the Raw Power shade. And I was like, let's just double it up as blush, move it out, be done. And then that eyeshadow ended up sticking around longer and longer and longer than I thought, even though I was multitasking it. So I was like, I didn't get quite... you know, the use I would have out of this blush normally. But now I'm back to using this exclusively and we're gonna do it. We're gonna hit pan on that sucker. Then lipstick wise, I worked on my MAC World pencil. As you can see, I have finished it. It is in the cap. And then, excuse me, I was working on a Clinique Lip Pop lipstick in the shade Cola Pop. It had expired on me. I went back and repurchased it. That tube had expired. I went and took it back. Explain the whole situation. So I've decided not to repurchase that lipstick a third time. So what I did was I went through and actually found a drugstore dupe for you if you are interested and you like the color. I'm actually wearing it on my lips today because it is quite a similar color to what Clinique Cola Pop looks like. And this is from the brand Joa. The lipstick is called I'm Your Jelly Bae. It's a matte gel lipstick in the shade Boothang, but this is what the packaging looks like. And I love that, you know, when you're storing them upright in your makeup collection, you can see the actual color. So when you're just looking through, it makes it quite easy. The formula on this is really smooth and comfortable. I'm not a fan of the fragrance of this, but in a pinch when I want a deep red lipstick that is very similar to this Clinique Colourpop blush, this is a great alternative, and you can find it at the drugstore. The other lipstick I was thinking kind of on hand, it's not quite as red, but Wet n Wild's Cinnamon Spice, I think is the shade name. And since I've noticed that Walgreens is clearancing out a lot of the Wet n Wild lipsticks, CVS's as well, I guess they're going to repackage them or reformulate them or something. You can get those for, I believe, half off. I don't remember what the closeout price was, but I did pick up on the tube of cinnamon spice, just because, like I said, the smell on this is kind of intense. So if I just want the color, fine, and then I'll keep the Wet n Wild one in my purse so that it's ready to go. Then the last two things I was working on, I was working on taupe. When I finished off or gave up on the Clinique ColourPop, I went on and pulled this MAC taupe lipstick out of my collection. I wore it quite consistently, so it's not gonna look like I made a ton of progress, but I have worn it a lot. And I'm continuing to toss it into my makeup bag, into my purse. So I plan to use up what I can of this within the next few months. We'll see what happens. I also was able to finish off my MAC Costa Rica liner. I have since moved to a Pure Cosmetics kind of a self-sharpening pencil. So I really, really enjoyed this. This is one of my favorite liners of all time. I just love how pigmented and opaque it is, but how soft and creamy that pencil is. And then lastly, this was one of my favorite products to use. I did not get to finish it, but it was one of my favorite products. It is the Michael Kors Sexy Ruby Rollerball Perfume. And when I... Okay, so that is it. I feel like this was beyond successful. I am thrilled with what I was able to accomplish, even though this blush, man, is just like hanging on for dear life. But I'm gonna continue working on it and having fun with it. I'm excited to jump into some new project pans. So thank you so much, Abbie, for just being inspiring and motivating and being the lovely person that you are. This was so much fun, and I really feel it gave me a great start into project panning yet again for 2019. So thank you so much for giving me a little bit of your time today. I really appreciate it. I appreciate you. I hope you have a fantastic rest of your day, and I look forward to catching up with you soon. See you later.